Myself, Dr. Krishnan Pandey from Life Supporters Institute of Health Science. Today we are going to learn about something, a device which is known as non-breathable mask to oxygenate our patient. So in this COVID scenario, what does it mean by that? So it means that no part of exhaled air portion is being inhaled with a non-breathable mask. The exhaled air goes out of the mask. So when the patient breathes, it breathes a pure oxygen which is going to be come from the mask. So now let's understand the mechanism behind the NRBM. Now understand what is rebreathing and non-rebreathing. Okay, now let's move. Okay, so now we have to understand what is rebreathing and non-rebreathing. So for that, I will demonstrate something. So I'll take a paper bag here. Now just look in this bag. What happens? I'll tell you. So what we have seen here, when I breathe or when I exhale the gas out, the gas is collected in the paper bag. So when I inhale again, I'm inhaling my gas again. So this basically clears you out the basic concept about breathing, rebreathing and non-breathing. So when I inhale again, I'm basically rebreathing my own gas. So when we talk about the non-breathable mask here, I'm not going to inhale my own gas. So that is non-rebreathing. Okay, I hope that it makes you clear about the rebreathing and non-rebreathing part. So here, there are two parts are there. Expiratory pathway and inspiratory pathway are the both different pathway. So when I, in this non-rebreathing mask, when I inhale, so basically I'm inhaling 100% of oxygen. So for any procedure, the patient can exhale also, there will be aerosol which would be there. So for our own protection, we should wear the protective equipment, that is a mask and wear the gloves. Now this is a procedure. For any procedure, you want to make a person understand, make a patient understand what is the procedure going to do. Okay, so I'll introduce myself, I'll take the consent of the patient. After that, we are going to move towards the next thing. So now this device is known as non-breathable mask. Okay, so in the previous part you have understand about the breathing and non-breathing part. Now, as you can see here, there are three compartments are there. There is a mask, there is an oxygen port is there, and there is a bag is there. So in this bag, the oxygen is going to be collected. Okay, in the mask, now this mask is a special type of mask is there. As I said, the patient should not inhale his own gas. There are two pathways are there. There is one exhalation pathway, so you can see there are two flaps are there. And there is an inhalation pathway. There are three flaps are there. So when the patient will inhale, so what happens here, the exhalation path or the exhalation port will close and the inhalation port, it will open up. So the patient will take 100% of oxygen. Now when the patient will exhale, so what happens here? So the air, the gas, the patient exhale should not mix with the oxygen, pure oxygen. So the exhalation port will open up and all gases which the patient has exhaled out, it is going to move outside. Okay, now let's learn how to apply the port. So this port is going to be applied in the bag, in the flow meter. So what I'll do, from the humidifier, I will apply the port here. Now, this is a special device. So it has a special flow rate. It is a flow rate from 10 to 15 liter. Okay, what is the first thing you have to do? You have to open the valve. So when you open the valve, you can see here, the bag is going to fill. It should be 1/3 filled. So what happens here? The all gases which is going to be accumulated, all oxygen is going to be accumulated in the oxygen reservoir bag. So now I have applied 12 liters. Now this 12 liters is going to be applied towards the patient. So avoid, never dispense the oxygen less than 12 liters. Okay, so it is not, NRBM is not intended to function with a lower flow of oxygen. Now do not allow the bag to collapse. Why is it like that? So when the bag, when the patient inhale and the bag collapse completely, it indicates two things. At first, the patient oxygen demand has been increased. Second, that there is a depletion of the oxygen support. So this will help you out to understand the both things. So we have learned multiple things now. We have learned the theory part. What is breathing, non-breathing? Now let's understand, let's learn how to apply non-breathing mask. So let's go to a patient. Okay, So I've applied my flow, I've applied my MNR beyond with the flow meter, I've adjusted the flow that is going to permeate. So what I'll do, I'll apply the mask on the face of the patient. I've taken the consent, I've taken all the personal protective equipment. After applying the NRBM, what is the next? So there are chances of the aerosol that can leak outside. So what I'll do, I'll take the surgical mask and I'll apply the surgical mask on the patient face. Okay, so this will help us to decrease the aerosol. Now, after applying the mask on the face mask, so I'll ask the patient, are you breathing comfortably? So if you say yes, this indicates that we have applied a proper NRBM. Now, since there's an oxygen scarcity is there, so what are we going to do here when the NRBM is not in use? So what we're going to do here, we have to stop the flow meter, stop the oxygen. But when the patient is under NRBM, so there is less chances that he can move from the bed to the washroom. Okay, thanking you for listening to me, and you can visit our Facebook page that is Life Supporters, and you can also visit our YouTube page that is Life Supporters. And for more information or for more any questions, you can mail us on info@lifesupporters.org. Thank you.